So you may be wondering why you're having a tough time dealing with change. Now, change is one of those kind of things that a lot of people, you know, you attempt to do something and you feel like, man, this just isn't working out, and then you end up going back to the same old routine, and you get so frustrated and mad at yourself for not being able to make that change, right? That change that you know would bring you perhaps more money, bring you perhaps a better relationship, bring you all these different things, but yet you find that it is still a struggle to try to adapt that change into your life. Now, my name is Marcus. This is Discover Ignite, where we discover possibilities and ignite change. And I myself, you know, I've felt that hardship, right? Trying to adapt to change. Now, to this day, I seek change, right? Because I know change allows me to grow personally and helps me, you know, develop myself and allows me to be a better person for myself, for my friends, for my family, you know, any kind of relationship I have in my life. And for me, I find that there was a time in my life when I really struggled with change, right? Whenever I thought about any change that was coming into my life, you know, I would have butterflies in my stomach. I would, you know, try to find a way out. I would always look for a different way, look for an excuse so I wouldn't have to make that change, right? It was so much in my head about why that change wouldn't work out, right? Maybe I felt like I would be embarrassed. Maybe I felt like I would make a fool of myself and, you know, people would laugh at me. For whatever reason, these are just the thoughts that I was thinking about, you know, trying to adapt to change and go against the grain. You know, I was fearful of lots of change, and a lot of times I would seek to go back. A lot of times when I saw that change and I, you know, tried to pull out of that change, I would try to go back to my old routine. And then a couple months down the road, you know, I might feel okay for the minute, right? Because I got myself out of the whole situation, and then I come back around to it and I'm mad at myself. I'm frustrated because I didn't adapt that change into my life, right? I thought it was a great idea. I thought it was something that would improve my life in some way, shape, or form, right? Make me a better person. And then come to find out, you know, I came up with an excuse. I backed out of it for whatever reason because of the way I was feeling in that moment right before that change, right? Or maybe that change occurred and I didn't put any time or effort into the trying to make sure the success of that change, that it actually, you know, forced me back into my old routine. So this is where you could be at today, and maybe you feel like, man, I really want that change in my life. I really want to be able to incorporate this change to make my life better. So how do you do that? So the best way to actually incorporate this change is to actually stop beating yourself up, right? Stop the negative talk. Start looking at why you're backing yourself out, right? Because a lot of times we play this, you know, song essentially in our head about why we can't do it. We start identifying ourselves as, well, we can't make this change because that's not the person who we are. But who defines who we are? Maybe there was an event in your life. Event in your life that caused you to believe that you couldn't adapt a change like that in your life. But this is where you have to start. You have to start from the mental aspect and try to stop identifying yourself as whatever that was, whatever event that was in your life, in your past, that wouldn't allow you to become this person with this change that you're trying to seek. You need to remove that. And by doing that, you need to, you know, go away with the old story of yourself and who you are. You need to incorporate this new person, right? What would this new person that you are trying to make the change and be, how would they go about it? Start trying to incorporate that. Start trying to incorporate some positive self-talk, right? About, you know, I know you can do this, you got this, you know, get up every morning and tell yourself, I'm a positive person. Whether you're trying to make a positive change in your health, you could say, you know, you are a healthy person, you make good choices. You know, we are all weak and we all do make mistakes, but that's not going to deter me from making mostly good choices, right? And this is what you have to tell yourself every day. Right? If I do make a poor choice, you know what? It will be okay because my next choice immediately after that will correct me and put me back on track. Don't allow yourself this negative self-talk about how you're not going to be able to do these things because you weren't ever faced with them, right? You weren't ever exposed to these specific choices. So how does that fit into your life, right? How does that not allow you to be whatever that change is? A lot of times, you know, we think we can't do it because we don't know enough, when in fact, you know, you always will know enough, right? Because a lot of times you can sit and you can, you know, try to come up with all this different information and, you know, you're wasting time, you're spinning your wheels a lot of the times, because you won't really know until you get your hands dirty, right? Until you get your hands dirty with that change. Once you start doing that change and trying to adapt this change in your life, you realize that it's that all that prep work you were trying to do beforehand, you know, sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't, but the majority of the stuff you were looking for did not help at all, right? You have to change a lot of things on the fly. But you have to realize that, you know, once you get over that mindset and you start allowing this change to become part of who you want to be, then it starts becoming the norm. Then you don't feel so out of place. Then you don't feel like, you know, you're this person who's essentially, you know, being something that they're not, right? And this is ultimately what you want to do to be able to adapt this change into your life. A change can be hard, right? Especially if you don't know and you're trying to make changes and so you are going down this path. But the thing is you'll make good choices and you'll make bad choices, and not to beat yourself up on those bad choices. So adapt whatever change that you want into your life. And a lot of times you have to set yourself up for success. Right? And this is where a lot of times you can do some kind of prep work the day before to help set you up for success. Because a lot of times we like to use excuses. Maybe we don't have enough time. Maybe we don't know enough. Maybe we don't, you know, this isn't in our wheelhouse, right? But that's okay. You just have to keep trying. Every day you make those choices to change, to incorporate that change into your life. You have to set yourself up. Stop talking negative about yourself, about why you can't do it, and how this is not you, because it's all a lie, right? We tell ourselves lies so that we, you know, can believe them and back out into that story and not allow that change to occur. And so we can feel safe in a position that we get tired of, right? In a position that we are not excited about, because we're not making any progress. And I've always believed that in life, if you really want to enjoy life, you do those challenging things and you realize that yes, it can be tough, but you know what? Once you make it through, you're proud of yourself that you did it. And then you seek other changes. And this is where I'm at in my life, to where I'm pushing myself and seeking new challenges. And I think you are wanting to be there too, because you are watching this video to try to push yourself, to challenge yourself, to adapt new changes into your life, to make your life better. And so you just have to focus. You have to set yourself up for success first by the mindset, and then set up whatever prep work you have to do the night before so you can make sure that you're doing whatever it is that will help continue your success. And the biggest hurdle is just getting out of your mind and thinking that you can't do it and making that progress. So just understand this, and understand that change is good. You will get there. You will push through, you persevere. You will, you know, stop feeling nauseous. You will stop worrying about what could possibly go wrong if you adapt this change. Yes, some people may not like the change that you're making, but then maybe, again, those people are part of that change. Those people have to go be removed, because that change is something you want in your life. And that could be something that maybe, you know, you're having a struggle with. But a lot of times changes that we want, some people can't be part of that. And that could be tough in itself. But you have to realize that some changes do require sacrifice. So remember what it takes to make that change. It's going to take a lot of sacrifice. It's going to take a lot of different things that you don't see from the forefront. But realize, if you want change to stick, that you're going to have to do a couple things to make that change stick. And talk to yourself. Because I'm guaranteeing you, if you can talk to yourself a lot more about why this change is good for you and understand why you're making this change, you can do it. You can push yourself. You can find the motivation to do it. You don't need somebody else telling you this is why, because you already know why you started it. Continue to push yourself and you'll be just fine. I believe in you and I know that you can. Till next time, I will see you guys later.